Hello everyone, welcome once again to Investing with a Difference. So it has been a long time since we did a video. It has been a busy time for us as we are coming towards the end of the year. While a lot of things we are planning right now, I think I've been talking about it previously. There is a lot of activity from the EOS development front which we have undertaken. We are doing certain developer group organization. We are doing a lot of developer outreach. So you will see more and more details about that. I think, as I keep saying, it's a great time to build and it is a great time to invest in your projects. And that's what is happening on in EOS world. So let's get quickly onto what is happening around. So some important news which I think you should look at and understand what's going on. So first of all, let's come back to the market. Overall, I think Bitcoin has kind of stabilized in the 3,000, 3,500 area. It has jumped quite a bit in last couple of days, almost 10%. And the biggest thing to notice is that EOS is now back to number four, and it has relatively outperformed in this jump when the market started recovering. For good reasons, I think we have been talking about how EOS is really performing. It's really a working blockchain with amazing performances. So we do not have to talk about that. But what really happened is there was an outperformance against Bitcoin. So if you remember, I was looking at this chart. Sorry for this. So I was looking at this chart at the long-term trend line for 2018. If we look back, while we had these peaks, but we were tracking this trend, and we had dropped below that trend at certain point when I got bearish and I was worried about how low it will go. But what happened in the last couple of days, it has actually jumped above that kind of long-term trend, which is very encouraging. And it was a huge outperformance. In addition, what happened is because of all the drama around Bitcoin Cash and this fight between Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin SV, as they're calling it, you see that both of them are now settling down below, and there is no resolution of these two coins, and that's also helping now settle down that EOS is attracting more money. I heard a few other research houses and the crypto firms, they have been upgrading EOS, looking at the performance, and that is again one big part in why it is going up. So I think overall it's pretty exciting. I think we are seeing some clear, like, you know, kind of turning around of EOS. It may be an inflection point. Nobody knows where the bottom is, whether we already saw the bottom. I think a lot of people were, when we did the poll on Twitter, I think a lot of people were still buying and a lot of people were holding EOS. So I appreciate that people understand the strength of EOS project and people were holding it. And I hope that you will get rewarded in future because see, the pricing, as I keep saying, the market keep pricing a project at a certain level, but the performance is out there for everybody to see. Now, coming back to what else is happening, of course, the Telos launched. So this was a big news. I think this is one of the sister chains which people were looking to understand how it will perform. So it is still early days. They have not activated transfers, but you can set up your wallets. So if you go to the Telos Foundation site, they do have a squirrel wallet, which is very similar to Grimace. I think they forked it at some point. But remember, there are some bugs. I'm myself struggling with some of the key changes I was doing. I was trying to change the keys. So be careful out there. Wait for maybe user. If you don't be in a hurry, your tokens are not going away anywhere. Because this is from a Genesis snapshot, if you were there on EOS, and you have to use your Genesis keys. And you may want to move your EOS tokens out of that if you are still using the Genesis account and the keys. So the account is different and the keys are different. You need to understand that whatever account you will create on Telos, that can, even if it is the same name, it will be a different account. It's not an airdrop, it's a parallel network, it's another chain if you want to claim it. And Squirrel wallet is nothing but a Grimace wallet fork, and you need to choose a different network. So it's a little more involved, a little more complicated. So be careful out there. Do not mess with your EOS account while you're trying to create it. Learn it before you jump onto it. But overall, I think it is ready now. At least you can start seeing your accounts, even if you don't want to enter your keys. All the Genesis accounts are created on Telos mainnet, just like EOS mainnet automatically created accounts. So you can go and you can monitor that. What else is happening? EOSDAC, which was the decentralized autonomous community, and this one of the block producers for EOS, they have opened up the voting. So now the custodians, as you know, there was interim custodian, the original team, and you can go and vote. And I would like to announce my candidacy for that custodian for EOSDAC. So you can see here, it's investingwads, as you already know, our account name. Please go to the portal, do vote. It's a very similar model they are using, that 15% voting will activate and enable the DAC. And this will be the first decentralized autonomous community running on EOS. And it's very, very important, I think, for the overall ecosystem. We believe that future lies in decentralized autonomous community. And that is how things should be run, where it's a democratic driven processes. And this is one example of EOSDAC, which is actually working on EOS, running as a block producer candidate, running as a kind of a community which is going to do more and more work in EOS world. And that's where I think you need to go and participate in it. So anybody who is a EOSDAC token holder, if you have not sold off your EOSDAC tokens, you can just go to the portal. We will post the link below. You can use Scatter to log in. So you can just go here. Currently I'm logged in, but if I log out, you will have an option to log in just like any other dApp. You can go and log in. You can vote for the candidates. There will be 12 candidates who will be selected to run the up to 12. It's not like necessary that it will be 12, but up to 12 candidates will be running the DAC as a custodian, taking decisions on the future of this DAC. And as I said, that I believe in it. It's a very, very important thing as a proof of concept, as a community which can run in EOS world. So do vote, and if you consider for voting, you can ask any questions on this YouTube channel how to vote. Finally, in EOS world, recently I think the CPU has been an issue, but what happened is it's mostly because of bad dice. I think Dan had came back and gave them suggestions of how they can reduce the number of operations. So bad dice, as you know, is consuming almost more than half of the CPU on EOS mainnet right now. And today, interestingly, bad dice is down. And what you're seeing is, I've never seen this in my account on Investing with the Difference, that we have 5 minutes of CPU left. That means almost 0% consumed. So this is a very rare time. Do participate in, try to, if you have not interacted with EOS dApps, try to use EOS right now. You can do millions of transactions for very little cost. And this is a very rare time, unfortunately, because of the bad dice and the kind of app which is attracting a lot of gameplay that is usually blocking the CPU. And that's why I think that people were frustrated. But as you can see here, one more thing which I tried while I was also struggling with CPU at some point, you see staked by others. So this 2000 EOS CPU, I actually went and leased from Chintai when I was suffering from lack of CPU for some of the dApp interaction. And what happens is, it's not very difficult to get this. It's like it happens immediately, and suddenly you have a huge amount of CPU available to you. It changes the way you see EOS network. Now, this is important to understand that how this will work in future. So Chintai right now has maybe 10 million or so kind of liquidity. Not a lot of people are staking with Chintai. But Rex, it will open up maybe 100 million of tokens, and the cost of leasing will come down further. So anybody can afford it and use the network. And that is, I think, you need to be very clear that whatever you are facing right now, because you're owning EOS and you are paying for it, and you're saying, why am I not getting enough bandwidth? But it will change if you do not have to own it. You do not have to own EOS tokens. You can just lease them. So as an investor, you will get the Rex benefits as returns. And as a person who is interacting with dApp or running a dApp, you will be able to lease it at a much lower cost. And already Chintai cost is not too high. Yes, it can be high if you are not really using it for productive reasons. But if you're using it for productive reasons, it's not very expensive already. And you can understand that it's a very, very small supply, which is creating that kind of a cost. And as the supply increases with the same demand, I'm sure that is the solution which Rex will provide. Of course, there will be side chains, there will be other parallel scaling of EOS that's going to happen, that's bound to happen. But at this moment, without leasing, actually, you can try out because, as I said, most of you will be having a huge amount of CPU at this moment if you're watching this video and if BetDice doesn't come online immediately. So there's a rumor going on that BetDice is off because of some hack, but what I'm seeing on their site is that BetDice is actually updating and they are adding some new games. So we don't know exact reasons. Also, as I said, Dan had given suggestions on how they can improve. So it's one of the leading dApp on EOS, which is attracting most of the volumes. So I think right now I see that they have put up some posters, that Blackjack coming soon. They have a lot of other games which are already running. They have Baccarat, they have Dice, which was the original game, and so on. So all these things are going to be interesting to see how this ecosystem keeps maturing. So this is where we are. I think there are a lot of news. I think Telos happening verbally. Already we talked about in previous videos. It's moving ahead. It's the chain is live. We have EOS outperforming now while the market is trying to find a bottom. Hopefully, when we touched around $3,000, $3,100, there is another target I think a lot of people were tracking. I'm not into predicting bottoms, so I'm not going to call it a bottom yet, but it's looking promising. Let's see how this holiday period plays out. Usually it's a very volatile period. Either it goes up or down in the traditional days in the crypto world. And just do watch out for that. But I think it's very exciting to see EOS outperforming. And as I said, we are going to do a lot of events. We are doing our holiday mixer with developer groups later this week. And we are planning a kind of a lot of activity in Silicon Valley. We are bringing a lot of apps on board. We are starting an incubator where we are going to develop apps. So if you have ideas, if you want to join the incubator here, right here in California, Silicon Valley, do reach out to us and we will be sharing more and more information very soon. So thanks once again for joining. And I hope that you're enjoying the holiday period. This is a great time. Spend time with your families and do have a good time. So thanks a lot, guys, and look forward to talk to you again. Bye-bye.